Okay.
Roll down tide.
What is going on, everybody? Christian Bauer here, Ballard Sports Media, coming at you with my official 2022 Auburn Tigers preview. Oh, this is going to be fun. Oh, my gosh, especially with all the Brian Harsin news lately. Now, I'm just going to be honest. I want to try to be as unbiased and, you know, just forget me being an Alabama fan for a second. Yes, I hate Auburn. That's part of it. I hate them with a passion. I love the rivalry, though. I got respect. I don't hate the players. I don't hate the coaches. I don't hate the fans. I look at their logo. I want to puke. It's color what it is. But not here to necessarily talk about the Iron Bowl rivalry or whatever, although it's part of the schedule. We'll get to that later on. We are here to preview the 2022 Auburn Tigers in football. 2021 summary real quick. Bo Nix gets injured. He's out now. He's gone to Oregon. 2021, I'd say it was a good start for Brian Harsin in a way. I do think the whole him possibly being out the door, getting fired because of how last season went, the losses were not good losses. To finish 6-6, if they had beat Houston, that might be a different story because they would have won a bowl game. But they lost that game, and I think that's where I would come into play. I'm like, come on now. And you got to look at this. It was how the second half of the season after the bye week. Like, normally, right, you go in to a bye week in football, and you might have a couple games losing. And even if you're winning, you know what you do? You take a chance. You take that bye week. You use it to your advantage. And you can go out and win a couple games. Not going to win every game, but at least the next week, let's just go ahead and dive back. Let's review what they did for this. Akron 60-10. Yeah, thank God you won that one. No big deal. Cupcake game, Alabama State. Don't want to discredit teams in this state. You pull for in-state teams. But for Auburn's level, again, kind of a cupcake, a slow start. They go to a wideout at Beaver Stadium. They compete very well. They lose by 8 points. Okay, no big deal. Bounce back with a Georgia State win, although to only beat them by 10 is kind of ridiculous. Go beat LSU on the road. Not bad. Handle it well in Death Valley. That was a great night game. You handle it very, very well. You win by 5 there, but LSU obviously terrible. But it is a tough environment. And for Auburn to, you know, in their first 5 games go 4-1. And then, of course, we know all about Georgia. This game used to be in November, but Auburn, I guess, moved the rivalry because they thought it wasn't fair that they had to play teams like Georgia and Alabama within – a 2-week span, which I think is stupid. I don't care that they moved this game. I don't. It seems like Georgia fans are over it in ways. I mean, they got their national title. I don't want to hear y'all whine and cry about them still moving this game. But I'll tell you this. You ever move the Iron Bowl from the weekend of Thanksgiving, and I'll have a fit, son. You leave that game alone. I don't want to hear you, oh, we don't want to lose on the last week of the season, so we're going to put this maybe to start the season. No, bull, you leave it alone. Move whatever game you want to. You move the Iron Bowl. I swear I'm going to lose my mind. But they lost to Georgia. You lost by 24 points to Georgia. How sad. And again, no disrespect to Georgia. They were the champions. They had their Cinderella year. Bama's coming back this year. But getting back to this, they had a good run to start out. Then they lose to Georgia. They beat Arkansas. Arkansas, great team last year to start out. They disappointed halfway through the season. It's a good stretch here. I mean, win your first two, drop one, win two more. Basically, going into the bye week halfway through the season, they were 5-2. for first year Harsin, not bad. But this second half is where it's going to get interesting, folks. This is where it sucks. Bye week. Beat Ole Miss. Good job. Lose at Kyle Field. Okay. A&M, their only loss was Alabama. We already looked at them. Lose to Mississippi State. Okay. At home. Then you lose at South Carolina by 4. And then, which, believe me, this did get on my nerves a bit that it had to be this close. But the Iron Bowl, you lost it. I'm so glad, finally. Look, I don't care that Alabama lost the title. We finally won it. Jordan-Hare, been waiting on that for quite some time. It feels like forever, at least, because I know it was like only 2015. That's going back 6-7 years. But you got to understand, it does sometimes feel like forever with that stuff, because it's just, it's like the past 2 or 3 have been a curse there, and we lose it. And Bama hasn't always had the best record. So to go in there and get that win for Alabama, I was pretty happy. I was crying. I'm like, oh my God, it happened. But Auburn fans admit this, even though you lost the Iron Bowl, the 8-quarter ball game was pretty special, wasn't it? Yeah. Then you go to the Birmingham Bowl. Well, SEC has not normally done well in that game historically. You go to Birmingham, you play at the new Protective Stadium. I'd like to go to a game there, maybe UAB next year. I don't know. But you lose to Houston. Wow. I don't even know what the hell else to say, truly. But it is what it is. Overall, Bo Nix gets injured. TJ Finley comes in. He does okay. Brian Harsin, year one. I think they're lucky they made a bowl game. You know, I mean, think about it. Some of those wins were cupcake teams. Akron, Alabama State. And again, I'm not here. I don't want to diss on Auburn here. I don't want to make fun of any team. But a weak non-con schedule outside of the Penn State game, I mean, that kind of gave them a leg up to even have 6 wins. But they got a good outlook, I think, going into this year. It's going to be rough because of the Harsin news. Is he even going to keep his job? I still don't know. A lot could happen between now and August or September. They get guys back. Tank Bigsby is not transferring. You know, from what I understand, it doesn't seem like he's going to leave Auburn. There were rumors that he was transferring out. He comes back. Jarquez Hunter comes back, so you get a couple key running backs. Bo Nix leaves for Oregon. You bring in Zach Calzada. But you got some competition. TJ Finley still seems to be the go-to quarterback. If I were them, I'd give Calzada a chance and maybe try to run the offense. I think that he did great for A&M last year, had a good record and everything. I think their only loss was to Alabama for the most part, I think. A&M, or no, they beat Alabama. I'm thinking back 2 years ago. So they had some other losses, but what am I saying? Oh, Ballard, you're getting sidetracked. Don't act like you won that A&M. I know we lost the game. I know. But Zach Calzada, I think Calzada is a really good quarterback. I think he's got a strong arm. He's good in the pocket, awareness. I think he's got some mobility on him. I honestly would work with Calzada if I were Auburn and I had to work with a quarterback, I would take a chance on him and maybe start him, you know, and see what he could do. Maybe you give TJ Finley the chance and the nod at starter right away, and that's understandable. But again, we'll see. Bo Nix has gone off to Oregon. Bo Nix, historically, I mean, his dad played at Auburn, had it in his blood, grew up watching him. And he was not benched. You got to understand, he got hurt, and TJ Finley came in, and he just up and quit. He said, I'm just going to leave. Whatever. Okay. Moving on. Let's move on down the road here. Back to looking at the 2022 Tigers. So 6-6 this past season, bowl loss to Houston. Really not a good year, although in my own opinion, what I expected them to do going in, I think I said like 7-5, 8-4, so they kind of underachieved. But at the same time, I mean, I don't know. Would y'all say that Harsin did underachieve like people are saying? Do you think that they're lucky to have even made a bowl game? I don't know. I want to hear from y'all. But here we go. They got the 8A game on April 9th coming up here in a couple months. But looking at the actual season itself, start out kind of soft here. Mercer, San Jose State at home. Then you host Penn State. They got a really good, like, five-game home stretch here. Mercer, San Jose State, Penn State, Missouri, LSU. Then you get into some road games here. Go to Athens to play the Georgia Bulldogs in the Deep South game. Go to Vaught-Hemingway in Oxford. Play the Ole Miss Rebels and Lane Kiffin. See what they could do. Then you get a bye week, which I think is good timing here because you got a tough stretch to close it out. Arkansas at home. Arkansas could have some improvement at Mississippi State, A&M, Western Kentucky, and then you go to Bryant-Denny Stadium in Tuscaloosa for the Iron Bowl. So overall, I think it starts out kind of favorable, like for the first two games in Missouri or whatever. The Penn State game, that could be a good one. I think my grandparents have kind of talked to my uncle about trying to go to that game because he's an Auburn fan. My grandparents are Penn State fans, so I don't know. But overall, I think they, with this type of schedule, it's not completely easy. Outside of the Penn State game, non-con should be no problem, right? And again, trap games on here. Maybe at Mississippi State. I don't know. I'll have to preview them later on. But, I mean, it could be a trap game in the sense that how do I put this? Could they overlook them? Well, let's see. Are they – see, you got to think. Let's say if they beat a team like Arkansas, they get a little hyped up. They get kind of crazy. They come off a bye week. Let's say let me give you this scenario. They lose to teams like Georgia. They lose to Ole Miss on the road, back-to-back road losses. They've also lost to a team like Penn State, played it close at home for them, but they lose that, right? They got like four losses already into the bye week. And again, I'm giving you a hypothetical scenario. Do they go out and beat Arkansas? Let's say that. Now they're getting somewhere. Now they want to get a win, right? And they know A&M's down the road, and everyone's talking about A&M because A&M's having a good season. At Mississippi State, though, don't overlook that. Don't overlook that. That could be a trap. I don't expect Mississippi State to be too bad of a team next year. And again, we'll look at it later on because I really don't know, but I would expect maybe some improvement over in Starkville and Mike Leach this year. Some teams I could potentially upset, A&M, Georgia, and Alabama, right? And I say A&M's on there because, well, that's at home for Auburn. Is it really an upset? It depends on what Auburn's record is going into that game. Because, again, that's week 10 of the season. They've already played nine games or eight games. Would they be 4-4? Would they be... Like, what would they be? 5-4, something? I don't know. Overall, I think this is a tough year for Auburn. I really do. I think with all the Harsin drama, I think losing guys to the portal, like Bigsby or whoever, at least to start out, which again, a reminder, I think, let's see. Well, Tank Bigsby almost transferred out. He's coming back. From what I understand, he's not. TJ Finley seems to be the go-to guy. But you got Zach Calzada. Is Zach Calzada the answer? Here's the thing. I don't think he's bad. I think he'll be great. I think he's got some talent in him. I don't know about the coaching. I really don't. It all falls on Harsin. You got all this drama this offseason already. And domino effect, one thing after one thing after one thing. And it's just, it's tough to figure out. I'm just going to go ahead and call it here. I think they squeak by lucky. I'm going to give them, man, I don't know. I don't know. I'm going to be nice and do this, but don't get too excited. I'm just going to go ahead and call a 7-5, right? And let me just go ahead and say they got to play for 8 quarters, so, if necessary, for every game. But anyway, shout out to 4 overtimes in the Iron Bowl, though. The losses that I think are a guarantee that I could go ahead and tell you, I think they lose to Georgia. They lose to Bama. They could win the Penn State game, but Penn State brings in a lot of great talent. Could they potentially be starting the freshman Drew Aller right away? Is he going to be really, really good? I don't know. I expect Penn State to take a step forward and do pretty good this year. They bring a lot back. I think they just got better talent in teams. So I'll take a Penn State victory there. So I think that they start out 2-0, then they go 2-1, they lose that game. I think they can beat Missouri. I think they go and they beat LSU. I think they lose at Georgia. I'm going to call an upset, though, and say that they go to Oxford and beat the Rebels, honestly. They can't keep taking loss after loss, right? They already lose to Georgia. I say that they lose to Penn State bye week. Then I think Arkansas might get them. Are they getting a little too excited? I don't know. Bounce back. Maybe they could close, and it's possible they even lose this game. It is a possibility Mississippi State wins. I don't know why, but I don't know if Mississippi State's going to be all that good. I got to give it to Auburn there. They are going to lose to A&M. They have to beat Western Kentucky, because if you lose to that, not only am I going to clown you the week after for the Iron Bowl, I won't shut up about Auburn losing to Western Kentucky. And then, of course, you're losing in Tuscaloosa. They have not won in Tuscaloosa in 12 years. Going back to Cam Newton, Scam Newton, in the comeback. And then, of course, the fallout with Harvey Updike and all that. God bless his soul. So 7-5, you're lucky you're making a bowl game. I mean, that's a better record than what you had last year. And I know it might sound crazy with everything going on this offseason, but I don't think they're going to be the worst of the worst. And they might. Let's say if you mirror that record there and they go 5-7, they don't even make it to a bowl game. Would it surprise me? Not really. I'm kind of just being nice here to Auburn. I really don't expect much improvement. I don't expect a big year. But some wins in there. I think part of this is the non-conference schedule. I mean, you got Western Kentucky. You got San Jose State and Mercer. That's 3. I don't know. Auburn, y'all kill me. Y'all kill me so much trying to figure out you guys. I can't do it, but I'm going to say 7-5 for the Tigers overall. I'm just going to stop talking. I'm going to leave it to you guys in the comments section. Tell me what I'm missing here, why they're probably going to do better or worse. Oh, they might surprise you, Ballard. Maybe. But, again, we'll just have to wait and see. I love you guys. I'm going to get out of here. Jesus loves you. Hey, do me a favor. Hit that thumbs up on your way out. Please like, comment, and subscribe right here to Ballard Sports Media for more sports content. I appreciate y'all tuning in today. Thanks for watching. God bless. And as always, Roll Tide. Ballard Sports Media, checking out. Love y'all. Peace out.